never gets easier, especially in this heat. But yeah, welcome to another session blog. I've arrived at my other syndicate water. It's never featured on any of my previous diary pieces. So yeah, we're here today to learn the water. This place has handed me more blanks than any other place in the UK, and it's kicked me in the teeth plenty of times. So yeah, I'm here for a bit of revenge, to learn the water first of all. I'm not actually fishing today. I've come down with a load of bait, some markers, gonna learn a couple of swims, choose an area, prime some spots, introduce some bait, with a view then, and a few days later, coming back again, introduce some more bait to those areas, and then a couple of days after, come back and actually fish it for the session. So yeah, that's what we're up to. We're gonna get cracking now, we'll have a good look around, choose a swim, prime those spots, introduce the bait, and then hopefully everything will be geared up ready for our session about a week from now. So I'll stop waffling, let's get cracking. Yeah, chose our swim. To be fair, every single one looks amazing here, and every single one normally produces. Looking at the book that people have written down over the years, they do tend to visit all areas of the lake, but as you can tell, it's absolutely littered in pads right the way around the whole place. It's got snags, fallen trees are in, so there's plenty of places the fish can hide out and just keep eating the natural food in there. So why come out and risk getting caught on a boilie? So I've chosen a swim that's sort of centre of the lake, but it gives me access, you can see, to that reed line just over there. Normally you'd fish that reed line from the swim down, but I just feel from this side I've got more chance of pulling them away when I get a pickup. So yeah, that's the plan of attack. We're going to have two rods over on that reed line, and obviously my right hand rod's going to be out in open water. We'll find we'll try and find a hard area. The place itself is predominantly silt, an old silt mere. So yeah, proper smelly, stinky silt. So we've got to find a sort of a firmer area to present a bait on, really. So yeah, I'm going to get in the boat now, get the markers out there, find some spots on those pad line, introduce some bait, and we'll go from there. Right, so what I've done, I've come down to the next swim down. This is where all the boats are. Loaded the boats with the bait so we can get out there on those pads and introduce them into those areas. Before I've done that, I've cast out two markers as close to the pads I can get them, and then what I'll do, I can pick them up and literally drop them exactly where I want them, and that's where obviously the business rods are going to be once we get back to the bank and measure them out and whatnot. So yeah, we'll grab the oar, life jacket on, we'll go in and do some bait. Right guys, just approaching the pad line now, at some sort of about 80 yards, I suppose it is 80, 90 yards. So just gonna locate the markers and then we can pop them into position. As you can see here, marker one, and I'm fishing a good sort of 5 foot off the nearest pads. It's pointless fishing right up to the side of them. You just end up losing fish. The time you get out of your bed or whatnot at night and the stretch in the mono, they're going to be into the thick of the pads, and you, 9 times out of 10 you end up losing them. So yeah, that's the area there. Obviously I'm going to spray all bait around here, and I'll actually bait inside the pads as well, so any fish that are sitting in there, they'll come across the bait, find the boilie, find another, before they know it they've come out of the pads onto your spot, and I'll hopefully snare one. Obviously that's marker one, and I'll spin down here, if you can see that there. Marker two, just down there, and again, same sort of style. I'm a good sort of 5-6 foot off the pad line, which is plenty of room for the fish to pick up, but I've got enough room to hit the rod. So yeah, that's the plan of attack. a good sort of 30 yards between them both. I'm going to actually bait all these pads as well and all down there, and then come back and do it again in a few days' time. Right then, so that's the pad rods all sorted out, done and dusted, all measured out as well on the old distance sticks, and then I've just recorded everything on the Box's Swim Mapper app. So yeah, we're ready to roll for the session. Like I say, I'll come back down in a couple of days' time, introduce more bait into those two areas again. So yeah, onto the third rod now, the right-hand rod. This would be the open water rod. I wanted to introduce a bit more bait. Obviously the pad rods are just for boilies only. There's enough other food in the pads holding the fish there, so I don't want to introduce more like bits and pieces of hemp and all that, but in open water that's what I do want. I want to get the fish to the open area and keep them there longer. This is where I think lends itself to using particles and other bits and pieces in open water rather than in snags. So first things first, any mix you need a decent base. So that's what we've got now. That is crumbed up Pacific tuna. What I've done before I've came down here today, got a food blender at home, whisked it all up. Not into a dust as such, as you can see there. There's just odd bits and pieces, which will just be in the swim for a long time and kicking up all the time. That's the actual base of it. Now to that, I'm adding the nation's favourite couple, hemp and corn. Can't beat hemp and corn. It's a wicked mix. Been catching carp up and down the country and all over Europe for donkey's years, so you can't go wrong with those two. Mix them together, and then I'm just adding in the last bit, the magic itself, is the tuna extract. Awesome product. It's probably one of CC Moore's best selling items. We sell absolutely loads of it in the tackle shop as well. And that's it, those are the four items. Fortunately I've got the Baron over us at the moment, so I hope you can still hear me. But yeah, I'm going to wix all that together now. I've had a bit of a cast about. I've had a bit of that. But it sounds like Jonathan Watson. I've had a bit of a cast about, and I found a nice little clear area. Well, I say clear, it's all sort of silty, but the lead just felt down that little bit better. There was just a bit more of a rattle on the tip, so it just tells me it could be a polished area they're using. There's no gravel in here at all. It is an old silty mirror, so it was nice to find a nice little firm dump. So obviously it might be an area they've cleaned out of a bloodworm bed, or just something that they've made the actual ground a bit more harder. So yeah, going to whisk all this together now, get out in the boat, give it a good area, probably working on the area of a sort of a one-man ground sheet, and then literally I'll be positioning the hook bait on the session just off the side of it. Well, that's the homework done and dusted, all the spots are sorted, bait's been introduced. Like I said, I'll be back down again in a couple of days and do it all again, and then back over in a week for the session. I'll speak to you then. Oy. Well, we're back down the lake again. Set this down, and it's been absolutely smashing down with rain since we did that sort of first phase of homework. So I've gone for the welly and short look. All the rage in Milan, I'm told at the moment. But now I know it's going to be an absolute swamp down that place, so wellies are advisable. So I bought myself a secret weapon. One of these fellas, the prodding sticks. Now don't get me wrong, you always get a good feel down on a lead and on braid, but you really can't beat one of these kiddies. And if you've got access to a boat with one of these, it'll give you so much more indication of what bottom you're fishing over. So yeah, it's more for that open water spot I looked at, just to make concrete sure that I'm fishing on the firm silt and the lovely stuff basically. I don't want to be in that horrible gunky smelly stuff. So yeah, this is the tool that's going to help me do it, and it'll just get rid of any head gremlins I've got. So I'll stop waffling, and we'll get baiting up and confirming these spots. Right, to the lake. Right, we're out here just by the marker float, just there. So camera's looking back at me now. That's the swim over there. So we're just going to check if this bottom is as firm as we hope to think it is. Right, let's have a look. Okay, so marker float's there, so I'm just checking the area around it, and pretty firm, to be fair. So it was just as the tap the feel down, if you like, on the lead, on the braid. It is quite firm silt here, and sort of if you go sort of 10 foot that way, it goes into that horrible sludgy stuff again. But here, yeah, very happy with this. It's a nice area as well, a little bit bigger than the boat, so yeah, ideal. It's just starting to rain as well, which is perfect when you're out in a boat. But yeah, very happy. Right, I'll get the rest of this bait in, hemp corn and boilie, and get back to the bank. Lovely stuff. Nom nom. Come on, Mr. Fish. Come and have your golden lovely dinner. Well, that's all the prep work done. Literally, I can do no more. Everything has been calculated down to the last inch, to be fair. Pad lines sorted now, open water spot sorted. So literally in the hands of the gods now. I've literally done everything I possibly can to make sure when we arrive on the session, I can be as stealthy as you like. All the rods will be clipped up, flicked onto the areas. I've measured up the spod for the open water spot. So I'll literally just put half a dozen spods just to start the session off. And yeah, over to the carp gods. Fingers crossed we can bag a whacker, and I'll speak to you in a few days. Here we are, session has started, rods are out, bivvies up, and yeah, one happy angler. It's a beautiful summer's day, and I must have sweated about a stone in weight setting up here today. I've got a huge southwesterly pushing across the swim, and they did make life a little bit harder hitting that clip on that pad line, but managed to do it, and the rigs went down nice and tidy, so all in all, one happy angler. I'll just quickly run you through what we're up to at this point, hook bait choices and all that lot. So obviously for the past week or so, we've been baiting up the pads with the actual tuna and a bit of the live system, but it's been more tuna than live. So I've gone for tuna hook baits on both rods on the pad line, the left hand rod. Now I've gone for a bottom bait on that, but obviously with it, I've tipped it with a little bit of corn as well. Obviously when I've been baiting up, I have been putting in a handful of sweet corn as well. So I'm just trying to mimic what the carp have been seeing for the last week in that area. So the new ones from Enterprise, these are the washed out versions in the Frankie Warwick range. And I've been glugging that in the tuna extract for the last week or so. So that's all pumping all that loveliness onto the spots as well. Fish with a little tiny baby stick, and that's the left hand rod. So middle rod, again on that pad line. I've gone for a pop up on this one. Fished the multi rig on it. I love that rig itself. It's a great rig. It's landed me loads of carp, so got massive confidence in that one. And I'm fishing that on the corkball pop up as well. Again, and it's just about trying to, I didn't want a bright pop up in their face. I just wanted them to, if the fish come in, it's just they're used to seeing that sort of bait. They're used to seeing sweet corn, they're used to seeing the boilie, and that's all that's there. There's nothing else on that area. So that's the pad line done. The open water spot, now this is the particle area we've been putting the hemp in. Obviously we went out and we found the firm area with the prodding stick. As you can see, the mix has got a bit more colour in it this time. And what I've done, I've added a new ingredient in there, and that is the fruit super blend. It's got a bit more colour in there, it's a great product, it's full of attractors and whatnot. And I just think with that dark horrible silt out there, a bit of visual, and there's, yeah, as you can see, there's greens and yellows and pinks and all sorts in there. So it'll just help grab the carp's attention if they're out in the open water. With that as well, I put a few tigers and talon. Reason being, that's what I'm fishing on the hair. So again, I'm just trying to mimic the hook baits that are out there. So there's nothing bright and in their face and stuff. It's literally what they're seeing is what they're eating. And yeah, hopefully we can snare one that way. I haven't gone mad. I've probably put about 10 spobs out there to start with.
And I've literally just sort of spaced them out. I haven't allowed them to drop in one area. I've been a metre that side and a metre that side and that. So we've got a good spread of bait there. And there we go, that's what we're up to. Fingers crossed we can grab a carp. If I catch one out of here, I'll be absolutely over the moon. This water has been my nemesis for so many years now. And yeah, it'd be nice to get one for sure, without a doubt. Before we go, I've got to tell you this. In the week when we were baiting up and that, I was walking back to the van. There's sort of a bit of a trail up the top there. Walking back with it, I saw a hedgehog scurry into the bush as I was walking up. So I downed my gear, got some bait, and I crumbled up some of the life system and the tuna, and it literally came out of the bush and started eating on it. And it just stood there like I was its best mate. So I got my camera out, and it just let me film him. So there we go. There's the hedgehog eating our bait. So not only fish like the tuna, endorsed by hedgehogs nationwide now. Old Harold the hedgehog loves the tuna. Everybody loves hedgehogs, don't they? I'll stop waffling now and grab a cuppa. Right, speak to you in a bit. Well, good morning and welcome to First Light. Now I'd love to say I've set my alarm at this time because I'm carpy and I like the mist and all that lot, but no, I haven't. I've been awoken by an absolute tonking run on the middle rod, which has resulted in an awesome looking common. It's not massive by no means, it's just a smidgen size, 17 pound, but to finally get one from here is unbelievable. So I'm so happy to finally break me duct. Obviously it was on that pad line on the corkboard pop up, and yeah, you literally couldn't paint a better common if you tried. It's absolutely perfect condition. So yeah, I'm just gonna wait for this sun to pop its head up a little bit higher, and yeah, we'll show you the prize, but so happy. Let's get in there. Right, here we are. This is the prize at First Light. A lovely dumpy little common. There we go. How about that beastie? Nice little dumpy common from this morning. Proper chunky little thing. Nice broad and fat. But yeah, so happy to get this one. Finally to break me duck on this place. Feels amazing. And it just goes to show, if you do a bit of homework and get everything right, yeah, the results are there. So hopefully we can find his mum and dad a bit later. But for now, what a perfect looking fish. And I'm absolutely chuffed as. Right, I'm gonna get this fella back. The rod's already back on the spot. So here's hoping for another one. But so far, great result, good start. Excellent. Well, loaded barrow can only mean one thing, session comes to an end. Fortunately, didn't manage to get any more fish, but absolutely more than happy with that stocky common to start things off. I know I've got fish visiting the spot, so we've got that area, right? So yeah, I'm just gonna keep persisting really, you know, keep coming down, keep putting the bait in those spots and just trusting what we found. And hopefully, I know eventually, one of the big gills will slip up and we'll get our dream prize. But from now until then, I'll bid you a farewell. Thanks for watching. And I'll speak to you soon. I'm off to see if my hedgehog mate wants any more food. The footage seen here is from later that week. A big low front was moving in the following morning. Big winds, big rain, an opportunity not to be missed. An overnighter between work was in order. I'll let the video footage show exactly what unfolded. Well, we're back down the pond again, and it literally has not stopped raining all night long. It's been about 6 days since we did the main session, and I've just come back down for an overnighter, and right hand rod's gone this morning.
Yes!
I'm absolutely buzzing, as you like, to get another one out of here. So happy. It's a gnarly looking old Warrior, 20 pound mirror. But it was never about weight out of here. It's just about catching the fish, and they all mean so much to me. You would not believe. I'm absolutely so stoked to get one again. It's come on the right hand rod, the open water spot. I got down here, like I say, late last night. Put about five or six spawns out again over that open water area on that film silt, and just fished the yellow northern special just to the side of it, and it's took off this morning. So I'm absolutely made up, like you would not believe. I'm just going to wait for the rain to let up, and we'll get the old beastie out of here. But proper old looking thing. It's to think that this fish is probably 50, maybe 55 years old is just unbelievable. You know, it's been swimming around in here longer than I've been alive. So it just brings a whole newfound level of respect for these creatures. And I'm absolutely so made up. I can't put it into words, really. I'm just buzzing. I've got to go to work in about an hour's time. So. I'll be going as a drain rat, that's for sure, but so happy. Right, I'll stop waffling, wait for the rain to let up, enjoy me brew, and I'll see you in a bit with the prize on the mat.
Yes! Same rod's taken off.
Yes. I was just about to show you that gnarly old mirror, and this one's rattled off. He's a pig, sitting in his lilies. But we'll get these two fish sorted now, get them out, and show you the prizes. But. What a result, absolutely blown away. What an absolute awesome one. Don't think I could get more wet if I jumped in, to be fair. It's absolutely tonking with rain. And obviously this is the first one of the morning, the 20 pound gnarly Warrior. So I'll show you the prize first. Obviously there's another one. I can't believe rattled off again. Same rod, that open water one on the firm silt. And what a morning. What an absolute morning. This is the first. There she is. 20 pound, awesome looking Warrior. What an absolute cracking fish. And like I say, to have all that homework we did come right, and the spots that we worked on and baited up and pre-baited. Yeah, absolutely blown away. When it all comes good, it's all good. Show you the side. It's got a beautiful scale pattern on him, some like little tiny pinprick scales everywhere. So I'll try and get some close-ups of them. There we go, there's the other side of the beast. What a wicked fish. Absolutely blown away. Yes! Taking on a northern special, this little fella. Right, I'll get this one back and show you the other one. It was a little bit bigger. What a morning. I'm still getting my head around it, to be fair. Oh, so happy. It means so much, especially with all the work we've put in, the pre-baiting. But like I say, it's been the same rigs, same bait, same spot. It's just trusting in what you found, and when it comes good, I'll tell you what, it feels so amazing. Right, so this is the other mirror. Proper chunky one, at 28 and a half. And this is the same rod. Ooh, that open water silt spot. And again, I just whizzed out another
Northern Special over that spotted area, and yeah, it's rattled off. Ooh, smack in the face. There we go, 28.5 pounds of belly filled mirror. Awesome, so happy. When it all comes good, all that work we put in, it feels absolutely amazing. Right, I'll just spin around so I can show you the other side of this awesome beast. Yes! Woohoo! Happy days. Right, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed the vlog, and I'll see you on the next one we do. But for now, from me and this awesome little fella, I'll bid you a farewell, and we'll get him back to his watery home, but chuffed as you like. Yes!